Hello everyone, and welcome to the 12 Hours of Silverstone on simrace.org, which is the penultimate round of the GT3 Multi-League Championship. Joining myself today in the commentating booth as of last night is Mr. Dimitri. Hello.
Hello again, Wayne.
Hello, how are you today?
Well, a bit tired, but I feel really confident about this race.
Yeah, well, as we was just talking there about the race, we've got some, as I said on Facebook, we've got some breaking news, which is courtesy of some overuse of curbing last night. So we've had drivers demoted 5 positions, so we've now got the amended qualifying results for you now. We've got 3 wide on pole position, Independent Sim Racer GT2 are now starting 2nd, Carsten in X Factor Racing 1 have now moved up to 3rd, All-Star Racing 1 are starting 4th, Independent Sim Racer GT3 are 5th, RTM are 6th, X Factor Racing Team 2, which was Alex Rambo, he's been dropped back 5 places to 7. We've got RSR Gaming, which was Daniel Scorfenza, has gone back 5 places to 8th. We've got Wilgrave and GTR3 Racing in 9th. GP Racing, which was Bjorn Decken, also gone back 5 places to 10th. Racing Association 2 and 11th, Witchwood at 12th, RML Team 2 at 13th, RML Team 1 at 14th, Witchwood Call 15th, RML Team 3 16th, X Factor Racing Team 3 17th, Independent Sim Racer GT1 18th, LFS Racer are 19th, DOC Racing 20th position, Sim Racing for Holland 21st, OnlineMotorsport.com are 22nd, SRC SKS are 23rd, the broadcast team are 24th, Racing Association 1 are 25, Flat Sport Racing are 26, and VE Racing are 27. So, well, what do you reckon to that then?
That's a hard team name to pronounce, the guy on sitting on 23rd position.
Yes, we did learn this. It's Farkenmineshaft.
Yeah, something like that. I would think so.
me and Shane had great fun with that in the last round.
So, as you see, there's quite a few penalties given. There's like, let me check.
And what's going on here?
4 penalties.
Have you got control of the cameras?
No. Let me check again. No, I can't do anything.
No, not can I. Right, hang on. Let me be right back and just restart there. Oh, here we go.
I got it.
Right. We want then. We want to go to there. There we go. That's your pole sitter. This is a start. This is basically all the cars will get called out of the pits in qualifying order. The qualifying is done obviously on the Friday evening, because we run in practice session as opposed to race mode using the rejoin plugin. The league admins will call each driver out in the places that they finished, and they do a slow formation lap, really really slow speed, as the cars will come round, form one behind the other. Then we do one more formation lap, which is at normal formation speed, where the drivers are allowed to warm tyres and brakes, and then we go green. So, what's your prediction then, knowing that we've had drivers changing? It seems to be here, looking at my timing, that Carsten's in 2nd all of a sudden. No, he's just pulled slightly front of Sebastian.
Yeah.
So, it's an unusual decision by Independent Sim Racer GT2, because it was Ronnie Hannell that qualified the car, and they've decided to put Sebastian in for the first stint, which is... No disrespect to Sebastian, obviously Ronnie's quite a lot faster, so I would have assumed that, being that they are going to start in second position, that they would have put the fastest driver in to, you know, challenge Marius to take the lead there. As you can see, we've got plenty of police cars on track.
Yeah, I was just noticing the same.
Yeah, something to do with this, something the league admin started on the last race, that the top 10 qualifiers will get a blue flashing light in the cars for reasons I'm still yet to understand. I don't quite follow.
What wasn't it the race before, orange and blue light?
No, that's race department.
Oh. I thought that was this league. I saw it before.
Yeah, I think George Talbot did it as well on SRO with the different classes. Each class had a different coloured light, which was a pretty good idea, really. Like, especially when you're racing in the dark. No one's coming up behind you, whether it be a P1 or a P2 car with a different light. So it's quite a helpful thing to do, really. But I'm yet to figure out why we've got it in this league, because I can't see any advantage to having it. But that would be Mr. Lutzinger in one of his IDs.
It's more of an ID if you're running more like a mixed field where you have GT1 or GT2 cars, then it would make more sense. But okay, yeah, it's kind of cool and it's very useful in the dark, at least.
Right, I've got to move a driver. He's got to go. Awesome. So we want RML. Where are you? Ah, just been messaged here by Max Milland. It's to do with, it's to help the slower cars recognise that the faster cars, so when they're getting lapped, so they don't think they're racing against them, and that's what it's for. There we go. So that answers that question.
Makes a lot of sense, at least.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a blue flag.
Yeah. Now we know the answer to that. Nico wants the link for the broadcast. It's going to have to be a quick one, because we're just about to go green shortly.
Still not a formation lap, so still have time.
Yeah, I will apologise to the viewers if you hear me talking to myself and typing away. It's because if you didn't watch the qualifying last night, Shane Burke's unwell with man flu. And he's chilling out in his bed, all right for some. And obviously we wish him a speedy recovery. And because of that, it's me and Nico will be driving the car this week. So I'm communicating with Nico as well as doing the commentating. So it's going to be a long 12 hours.
Yes, and Nico will also be joining us now and then for a KO commentary. So we can, it's going to be interesting to ask how the race is going, how the car is feeling. So we will get a small sneak peek, you can say.
Yep, and I should try and do a talk round without crashing into a wall, which would be fun because I don't like to push to talk. I'm all arms and elbows with that, so I like to have my channel open all the time, but I can't, because otherwise all you're going to hear for however long I'm in the car is a inside of a Ferrari 458 screaming down me. But then to you, the advantage, I have to use push to talk, I still have to listen to Dimitri when I'm in the car.
Well, thank you, if I feel alright right now.
Yeah, but at least it's not as bad as listening to Shane.
Yeah, I would get frustrated and crash eventually.
Yeah, and we will say to Shane, if you can speak at all, if you've got a bit of voice back, come in and just have a little chat with us. Let us know
come to see
on and any other drivers or teams out there and spectators, if you want to come in and have a chat, you can message us on Facebook and message me. It says Wayne Reed, and send me a private message, or go to the broadcast team on Facebook and send us a message, and we'll give you the team speak info so you can come in and join in with a bit of fun and shenanigans. Here we go, starting the build up now to the full speed formation lap. This should be we're going into now. You see Sebastian there warming his tyres up a bit. If there's anybody you want to shout out to, send us a message and we'll give you the shout out. We wish all the teams and drivers the best of luck, and our German colleagues good luck as well.
Yeah.
And if there's any Germans out there, if you come over to our broadcast, Dimitri said he'll give you all €50 each. if he offers you sandwiches, say no, because you just eat them all.
Food is my life. If I don't have food, I can't commentate or stuff like, or anything.
Well, you've eaten more this morning than I've eaten in the last 2 days.
Yeah, well, I just ate again on the morning.
Oh,
I'm good to go for an hour or two.
An hour?
Yeah, an hour or two, and then I eat again.
Well, I've had 4 slices of toast at 7 o'clock this morning. That'll be me till about 4 o'clock this afternoon.
Damn.
And then it's yummy, yummy pizza time.
Oh, that sounds good.
Oh, yes.
I hope it burns. So you have to drive on an empty stomach. All hell will break loose for sure.
Not nice when I've got your support, eh?
So I'm
guessing... the broadcast car is basically our team car, you know, and you wanted me to starve to death at the wheel. You know, that's just it. So you're just jealous because I'm faster than you, and you know that I'll get fatigued if I don't eat.
Surely. So I'm guessing they're going to go for another formation lap.
No, this should be it. Don't forget, this is the old start-finish straight, so they'll go down the hangar straight and then come round there, and we should go green, green, green. Or as they say in NASCAR, boogity, boogity, boogity.
Karsten really trying to get some heat into his tyres for sure.
Yeah, I'll tell you, I'm interested to see how the start of this race is going to go. Because it looks like Sebastian, I think he's holding some sort of secret around here maybe. I didn't see what his lap times were in testing to know what he's got comparison to Ronnie Hannell around here. So whether he's got a little something up his sleeve and he knows he can take the pace. It'll certainly be interesting to see how quick Karsten wants to get past to start attacking Marius. We know Marius' race is very hard and fast. We could be on for a nice battle here between him and Karsten. One more corner to go.
Hoping for a clean and a nice start.
Here we go. 28 drivers. Had a problem. Nico's gone down to 28th position. And see if they all behave themselves or whether we get a roll by. Here we go. And we're off.
Yep.
The lunge I was expecting, I can't afford the car, I can't afford to go straight out the inside there into turn one.
Yeah, I was thinking the same, that he had a good start. But it seems no position swaps yet.
You see, this is where Sebastian may well have the advantage, and I do believe they're carrying a lot less weight than what Carson's carrying, so. But we also know that the Elk is quite quick and straight, looks like we're going to have a move here up the inside by Carson.
Well, something changed, I didn't push anything.
Yeah, Carson's gone into second position. We'll go... there we go. We'll see, we can challenge how quick he catches Marius now. That's the usual flying start from Mr. Willem. A few changes for position down the field. It seems Nico's gained, he's gone up to 25th position, so he's had a fantastic start, 4 places in half a lap. So, that food that Nico had this morning must have been a big bowl of Weetabix.
Well, Carson, surely on
we've
a
got a
flying
battle
lap.
going on down there as well. Let's have a look. Where are we? I think this is it. Here we go. Daniel Scorfenza, this is one of the naughty boys from last night. He got a bit over-eager with curb usage. So, we'll see how quick he comes back up the ranks, because I believe he qualified third, didn't he? Originally. Qualifies position as penalty.
Yeah, I believe it was third or second. No, it was third. When we had Alex Rambo in
second, yeah.
Yeah.
For some reason we got a bloke in last being shown a blue flag. Oh, we've got someone pitting. Lazy man racing, they're in the pits.
Oh, we missed that.
No, that's not a disconnect straight away unless they've sustained damage on the opening lap. Maybe lost the front splitter somewhere. So it's an unfortunate start for the race then. Got the quickest first lap was Carsten, only by a tenth of it, was the fastest. Jake Bagg, considering he had to overtake Sebastian as well. Ah, yes, I remember that now. He just been informed by Max again, seems to be turning into our pit lane reporter. There's a 10 second stop and go penalty for Lazy Man due to a mismatch in a test race. It's a new rule that was brought in due to some drivers not using using the FIM sync before they join the server, and it's been the cause of quite a few server crashes. So a new rule that's brought in is any team doing so now, it now results in a 10 second stop and go. So thank you, Max, for that. I've forgotten all about that. Good TV work by myself, as per usual.
Well, Scorfianza was running a little wide over that curb again.
There's, Nico's up to 24th now. It seems it's going on. Let's just have a quick float through the field then, let's have a look. There we go, Marius Burt still being followed by Carson. This is, I think Carson's getting closer to Brock Sebastian by quite some margin.
Yeah, pressure still already.
It's that's some quick race pace. Fuel right up to the brim, so see whether Sebastian goes any further back. It doesn't look like anyone's challenging him too much. He's 5 tenths clear of the car behind, so just seems these two, as usual, are on a different track with just them two racing.
These guys are really flying. The gap is already 3.5 seconds from second to third position. That's huge. Ooh, Costum's right behind now. He's getting really close.
Yes. We did. We saw this in, I think it was Eastern Creek. Carson had this habit of managing to sit up someone's trumpet for a quarter some time, whether he will or not today. I don't know whether he'll decide to just go for it straight away.
Yeah, I think he wants that position. He's not gonna wait. He's gonna have a go around the outside now.
Seems to Carson's car's a lot more stable on race setup than it was in quality setup last night.
Yeah, we kept seeing the car oversteering at nearly every turn he took. That might be the reason
Seems,
because he qualified so low, that he might
Yeah, I
just
mean
qualify on race pace.
he did have a helping hand. Obviously Carson qualified sixth and gained three positions due to drivers being demoted places, so it's, I mean, that's helped him massively there, because it's five less drivers to overtake. It seems these two are level pegging for speed-wise. Carson seems a little bit quicker in the slower corners. Marius is quicker in the faster ones, and he seems to have good straight line pace as well. What will go on there? We also had Racing Association and Online Motorsports. They have both pitted, but that will be for penalties. So everything should be plain sailing now. I think they have to serve their penalties within the first three laps, if I remember rightly, so any driver that hasn't now will get penalised again if they've had to do one.
The gap's still building up. It's now 4.5 seconds from second to third. Ooh, and Carson's going, look in the inside, just not enough room there.
Oh dear. She's gonna be a long day.
He really wants to have a go already. And it's still more than 11 hours off to go. Just hope this doesn't
long
end
way
any
to go
bad.
Yet. Certainly seen it before. Marius is really quick. Struggled a bit at the Nürburgring, no, I do believe, if I remember correctly, struggling for pace around there for quite some time, but we'll see whether that changes next month when we do that race again, obviously due to the server issues that we had. That race is now being rerun as the last race of the season, which will be in a month's time, so we'll see if any teams improved on where they was originally. So I think for Carson to pull this off, it needs to be into sort of the Loughfields area, seems to be where he's quickest. Oh, that was a risky man in that curve that much. Can you get a decent slipstream down into here? He just can't stay close enough. So it's this part here where he seems to be quickest. It's supposed to show the caliber of driver that Marius is to be taking the pressure that Carlson's putting on him. So we will show you some other action in a minute, but we don't want to make the mistake of missing the overtake when it happens, because it's going to come soon. Oh, we've got All-Star Racing. Michael Rita has taken over third position from Sebastian. So it looks like he's trying to close in on the front running too. Let's see what he's doing in respect to lap times. Let's have a look. Yeah, he's actually been quicker. Last lap, Marius was a 2:01.9, Carson was a 2:01.6, and he was a 2:01.4, so we could well have a third driver joining the party. I think Dimitri's fell asleep again.
No, no, I'm still here. Yeah, sorry, I was chatting with my neighbour.
No, I thought you'd be eating or something again.
Nah, not for food. I already ate a bit. So I'm good to go for 2 hours.
Sure you ain't like half hamster or something?
What?
Sure you ain't been half bred with a hamster?
he's going
hang
for
on,
the inside!
Here we go. Could this be it? Could this be the lunge up the inside?
Yes it is! He's squeezed
yeah, he's on the flip
through.
Back. Don't forget, corner goes the other way.
No, that's
not
going to work.
It's where Carson's quickest, it's where it's going to come, I think. I think Carson needs to try and go around the outside of him, which isn't an easy task.
He's in the slipstream, he's going to need to go defensive. Is he? Oh, he's going to go from the inside already. Ooh.
Oh.
That's very dangerous stuff. Seems Michael Ryder is running alone as starting to come towards the first and the second man.
Yep.
He made
he's
a small
there,
gap.
In the background. Captain only by attempt to a lap, but if these two keep this up another 5 or 6 laps, and he could well be joining the party.
Although he would have to be careful how he takes the curbs on, because he was one of the people, if I'm not mistaken, that had the penalty.
So you can tell, yeah.
No, I was mistaken. Michael Ryder didn't have any penalty.
No, he would have. He started in 4th place, so he's gained a position on where he started. Oh, dear. We're going to see it this lap. The thing we've got to watch for is the way that Carson is with them tyres. He wants to watch that he don't run out of grip.
There's a spot before when he came to take a look.
Here we go.
Marius feels going defensive right now. He's on the wrong side.
Oh!
What happened to the camera?
Marius first gone.
Oh no. He disconnected.
Yes. Oh no.
Yes.
Oh, things
got
that early on in the race.
That was
shocking.
Was going to be a great battle.
Oh man. Well, that's just gutting. Yeah, we'll definitely disconnect here. That's their race. Run for the victory, at least. I mean, they may well. They could still get second place. I mean, there's a long time to go yet, well over 11 hours, and not get other disconnects. But I've never seen one happen that quick into a race before. I mean, we're only, 28 minutes into the race. Well, we're not even that, because it didn't start till, so it's about 20 minutes it's taken for them to get a disco. So that now promotes All-Star Racing Team 2 to second position, and Sebastian up into third. So we'll have a run down now, we'll see who's where. Oh, hang on, no, we're getting problems, we've got server crash. That's why we got the disconnect.
Yeah, maybe Marius had the same issue and it just
Yeah, it says Marius crashed. Is in the pit. Someone's came on here with a mismatch, so somebody hasn't synced. That's what's caused that. Somebody hasn't synced up. Alright, we've got Sebastian. There we go. Now being chased by Akeem in X Factor Racing Team 2. It'd be interesting to see where this will go. Sebastian certainly found some pace in respect of where he normally is in a race pace. I mean, he's a quick driver, but he tends to be a bit further back. So I know he struggles with car balance with a lot of the tracks. So it seems that he's found Silverstone. I think he's found a nice balance, and he's being able to show us what he can do behind the wheel, which is good. No, a good result for them. They're running on a good pace with Rocket Ronnie and Ronnie's dad as well. Shane, if I've caught your man flu, there's going to be problems.
Yeah, I'm getting sick already.
Because I can't stop sneezing and my nose feels funny.
Yeah.
We got fourth position. And the camera.
Nice little train over there.
A what, a crane?
No, a train.
Oh, a train.
What, a crane? No.
You sure you're on the right game then?
Yeah. I mean a small train of cars, yeah. You're so evil, stop making fun out of me.
Well, it's the rules of the commentating booth, we have to wind each other up. You know, I mean, we could get the guest star Cole to come on as well, and he can help join in the fun. As we know how much you love Cole.
No. Maybe just for a small interview or something about what he thinks about the race. Would we have a floating car? Might be the sink issue.
Yes, I think that's what's caused it. That's a temp car there.
Yeah.
How's it gone? There it is, that's behind
Mr. Leffman.
So there. It's Marius, I think.
Is it?
Let's have a look. Yep, yeah, that's Marius first.
Wait, why, how's this possible?
Because he's rejoined the server. And because we haven't gone back to the pit, his car skin's not showing. Trying to think if there's a way you can do this without going back to the pit. I'm going to have to ask the technical director. Stick it on the car behind for now. Marius did make it back then, so he's in sixth position at the minute.
Oh, and he's going for the overtake already. He's getting very close. Well, the car just looks a bit smaller, so I don't know. Must be annoying to race against something like that, and he's going for the inside already. Clean pass.
Where are you?
Who is that, Sebastian?
I'm not looking at a minute. I'm trying to find the boss. I'm going to lose a runner somewhere. Where are you? Where is he gone? Oh, there he is. He's back.
Marius is really flying. He's going in the inside of Sebastian and another clean pass.
Yeah, this is what you're seeing there. This is the GT car. It's been designed by HRT. It's as aerodynamic as a chess ring. seems to be quite a battle going on there for midfield. So, we'll keep floating down. We'll cover everybody. So, how did he get up to fourth place?
Yeah, that's what I just was saying.
Well,
he just overtook
Sebastian down into fifth.
He just overtook boats and forest in like 5 corners or so.
So you getting messages? Someone's team speaks binging and ain't mine.
No, it's not mine either. It goes Talker.
Who the chuff is it then? Getting nothing on mine. Right. I don't know then, must be hearing things. All good. So we'll go to 7th position. And this is in 7th position. RTM Racing. Green. Just driving for them at the minute. I can't get comfortable anymore. I feel like a pee on a drum. It seems to be quite a good race going on. It's not spread out as quick as other races, which is good for us. Eighth position. Yeah. That was one of the ones that's penalised, I do believe. That is RML Racing Team 1. Let's have a look, because I know that their picture was put up, so and they were naughty boys. Where are they? RML, yeah. They went back 5 places, they started 14th, so they're a good bad start for them then. They're up into 8th position, so coming through the field nicely.
And there's going to be an overtake just ahead of Maxion.
Yep, I'm on it. And the camera stops tripping.
There we go. No. Yeah, he got it.
Nice
move. Brave move. And Marius is already on the back of the Alpine.
Yes.
The GRLFX car.
I think he's going to try and close down Carsten. That's weird that they've come back up so quick. Unless they have taken the penalties off, because I think they was discussing not having the penalties with the rejoin anymore. That's the only thing I can think that's made them come on so quick. Because generally if you get a disconnection, you get the time penalty for the rejoin. You normally lose a lap. And it works out.
Yeah, that's...
He come back on in 5th position, so there's no way that they lose a lap.
I don't think they actually disconnected or something. It's kind of weird. It's like they lagged out for 20 seconds or so and they just reappeared again on the track.
There's that falling again. Oh, I wonder what it might be.
I saw a kind of glitch like that before. A race I had to do, there was a guy on the front row and they started and everyone was starting just fine like it was, and then it was like he just lagged back to his starting grid, no damage, and he just launched off. Kind of weird.
Yes, it's Facebook that's bonging me.
What? Facebook?
Yes. A notification, that's what we've been bonging us. Since it's interfering on, I think I'm going schizophrenic slowly, there's all these bits of things and bonging below the shop. We've got a car in the pits. We've got Mr. Yovanov in the pits, the same name since the Holland.
Oh.
Wow.
That's early.
Let's have a quick look, see what's going on down there then. Have they had a disco or is it just a standard stop? Seems to be just a standard stop. Wonder what's going on there then. Seems a bit early for a driver, for a pit stop.
Even already for a driver swap.
Unless he needs the toilet. Maybe he needs a toilet break or something. Or well, maybe they got an issue with the car. Maybe so it might have taken damage on, perhaps. Or a puncture. I've seen that a few times in this series. A couple of the teams suffering with punches.
Yeah, it could be the case.
Seems to be back off with no problems, and driver stayed the same, so it definitely wasn't a driver change.
Maybe some damage that we just missed.
Yeah, it could be something like that. Stone, they've changed their car.
Yeah, they're using a Corvette.
They normally have the old big old Ford GT.
Yeah, I do it the same. Maybe they got also tired of it.
Maybe they just seen the error of their ways and realised that it's a poo car. What like we did. You know, it's nice to look at and sounds nice, but other than that, it's about all that's going for it. So, let's get back to business. So, we was down, let's have a look at ninth position we was up to. So, see what's happening down there. Oh, they're all still having a party in the middle field here. This is Scorfenza, the naughty boy for the group. Coming back through the field as fast as well. There you go, that's a corner cut. Have you guessed him one? That was RML again, wasn't it? Mr. Scorpenza. Ninth there, RML. Nicholas Mackeshin there in the Ferrari was the one went wide there going onto the hangar straight. And there a bit too quick, took him by surprise. And we got it's Mr. Alex Piccolo.
Yeah, he's really looking close.
He wants to challenge Mr. Scorfenza for something or other. Oh yeah, Dimitri knows today, don't you?
What?
You know what today is, don't you?
Yeah, Saturday.
I know it's the day Teddy Bears have their picnic. This is an action that's coming anytime soon. So
wait. The Lamborghini's getting closer there. From Brown Decker. Apologies.
Excuse me. Can't win, I'm either sneezing, burping or farting. It's not a one-man band.
Yeah, and it's all Shane to blame for it.
Yeah, that's it. That's all we're doing. You know, me and Dimitri, we had a week booked in Barbados. We're about to cancel it. Think we'd be sitting on the beach now.
Ooh, he's going straight over the curves there. And he already had a penalty for that.
Yeah, I don't think they're looking too much about it in the race, as long as you're not being ridiculous with it, but I think there's more and more people doing it.
Oh, somebody's slowing down there.
Someone's on wide.
Yeah, that's the
these,
case.
These corner cuts are set on their fastest lap, so it's deemed as a gaining an advantage over other drivers, but race-wise, they're not rode too much as long as you're not being overly excessive and doing it every single lap and stuff like that. Because racing, you know, it's racing, isn't it? You're going to get times where you're going to make errors and take a bit much curbing than necessarily was going to. And qualifying,
yeah, well,
there's no reason for it, you know. It's private quality, there's no one around you, you shouldn't be cheating.
You know, it's always possible that you cut a corner like a little bit by accident, but yeah, if it's over-exceeding, then there has to be something done about it. It's as simple as that. I'm quite surprised they made it come true so fast.
Right, so where are we? Let's have a look. 12th place.
There. Karsten isn't getting the gap open to Michael Ryder. It still stays around 5.5 seconds. So he's keeping some good pace. Yeah, for sure.
Take it easy, he knows he's not under any immediate pressure. He's dictating, isn't he? That's all he's doing now, which is the best way, you know. 12-hour race, he's got the lead now, he just needs to dictate the pace. So that was 14th. I'm gonna have a look. Witchwood Court. There we go.
Wow, that's something you don't see a lot, an orange Ferrari.
And it's not just an orange Ferrari. That's the thingy colours. That's the General Lee.
Oh! Yeah, I didn't even notice yet. That's cool.
Yeah. Oh, it does, it looks pretty sweet.
Yeah, kind of
original. It's unusual to see anyone do it on a Ferrari.
Yeah, I must agree.
I've seen it done on a few Corvettes. I've never seen it done on anything other than an American car, so I'll give them 10 out of 10 for thinking outside the box. It seems that it suits it quite well.
Visual.
Oh, that was 14th place, here we go to 15th now. That's not 15th. Miss Carson's gone back. Oh, hang on, what's going on here? Witchwood are having a Barney with Independent Simulator GT1. So, let's try this again. There we go.
Oh, okay, I'm back. I just lost some visual for a moment there, so I was kind of blind.
That's helpful.
Yeah, probably Shane again. Scrappy internet.
Yeah, you've caught it, he's been sending viruses to him.
Yeah, I have to think so. I mean, this is not normal again.
Well, I did notice the nice thing last time when we had two separate connections for the broadcast. I was at a constant 16 FPS for the entire 24 hours, whereas Shane was at his usual 4. So, made for interesting. And then he had, you missed all the antics, because then something was going on with his internet as per usual. And he sounded like a Dalek for the best part of an hour, where he went in every room of the house. That's all you could hear. Yeah, so I could tell he was enjoying it as much as I was, because he was communicating to me on TeamSpeak, and everything was in caps lock, and we'll put it this way, none of it's repeatable.
Surely not.
Many words beginning with S and F and C and B. Oh no, hate, he did say hate quite a few times, that's repeatable. It's what he put before and after the hate that he couldn't repeat. I found it quite funny, but Shane didn't seem to agree. Right, where are we? What position did we just go? Yeah, so we go down to 16th now for a sneaky peeky.
I just noticed every time you're laughing, my RRT viewer starts to lag. It just actually freeze.
I'm starting to notice that, I don't know if you can spot it, but the way that they've done the black on the front of that Ferrari kind of makes it look a bit like a Nissan GTR.
thought you were going to say McLaren.
No, look, so you look at it.
Nah, it looks more like McLaren to me. Just because the blacks goes through, it's like the P1 or whatever it is.
Yeah. Well, yeah, at least I haven't named that one after a tight knot a lot of last ones. So who's come up with that name? I mean, was it the MP12-4C or whatever? What the hell?
No, isn't it MP412C? No, I don't know.
It's got a dash in there somewhere, isn't it?
Yeah,
MP12-4C I think it is, or something along them lines. It's like, what marketing Feb came up with that and thought it was a good idea? I mean, Christ, you'd be done with it. Someone stole your car and you're running the police, like, what is it, and you forgot what the sequence of numbers were, you'd be done with it. And they just call it the MP4 or something.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on. Steady, Fred.
Oh, around the outside, is it going to work? No, he's trying to cut back.
Yes,
he's gonna have it. No, just not.
Squeeze! Cool, steady on that.
He's just floating around that bumper. Please, this is an endurance race, it's not a sprint race. I know you're always eager to overtake and all, but you have to think out of the box. You have to think about strategy and about team members and their team members.
Yeah, but see, you might well know Giovanni, you know, just give it time.
Well, and at least the more overtakes we get, the more clean ones, the more viewers will be happy. And he's going for the inside again, it's a late lunch. He's not gonna make it stick. No, it's not gonna work. Yeah, he had to do it.
Oh yeah, you gotta go for it.
Oh, and something we missed. Mary's bird just he got past Akin Cross. And the gap's already like...
take him to catch up with Michael then.
It's already like 4 seconds.
I'm intrigued to know what's going on there. That's going to bug me until the end of the race to find out what the hell's happened to it. If there's anyone out there from Free Wide that's watching the broadcast, any chance that you can let us know what's gone on? Because it's confusing the hell out of me.
Yeah, it was a really weird thing. I don't know. Ooh, the curve, so far over the curve. Just battling hard. And they're going to a three wide battle. It's going to be a three wide battle. Oh, no. This is not over. Oh, even the BMW Z4 is there. God. Well, this is some heck of
a race. Looks like the Lambo, that's the worst for that.
Yeah, he lost the position.
He's come out 3 places back. That didn't turn out well for him at all. Sure, we got... where are we? Mr. Mission.
He's going back for it in the Lamborghini. He's going around the outside. Oh, he took it. Yeah.
So this is a fight for...
No, he doesn't.
This is a fight for 8th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th position. Right, so why? Oh, hang on, what's going on here? Quick. And these three are still having a right go at each other. Got someone pitting. Let's have a look, see what that flashes up as.
I feel like I need a bigger
screen. It's Alex Piccolo for Wychwood. That's a pity. 20 laps. That's an early stop. We kind of worked out, I think, last night that it's not caster sugar. That's the ingredients. Let's find the right page. Don't you just love that? Do somewhere. Too many pages of notes. Food on the way already?
Yeah, I'm hungry.
Yeah. You must wait.
Going so wide.
Where's my calculation?
Yeah, I'm getting a little bit confused with the qualifying timings and stuff.
Because I wrote them. And I ain't got it anywhere for some reason. And that's poo. Because me and Nico said it last night working this out before we went to bed. And I know I wrote it in here. Where has it gone? And I think it was 32 laps that the car takes on a full tank.
Andreas Lefkamp is battling heavy with Daniel Hake, and he didn't take the position. So good defending there from Andreas Lefkamp, I mean.
Buggered sideways, you won't know where it is.
I should blame Nico, we can ask him when he's done with his tank.
Here we go, I found it. Yeah, 32 laps in the full tank. A lap, if you use boost free, is 5 litres. It's sort of average 5 lap is 4 litres. Yep. And it's sort of 4 litres on boost 2, which is the average. So it sort of worked out if you do around the 2-minute mark, you should do 50 minutes per stint. So if you do 20 laps, he's got to be running on boost 3.
2 minutes.
When I was doing my testing, when we run boost 3, if I put 13 laps of fuel in, I was getting just shy of 7 laps, I think, so... He's got to be running on boost 3 to be stopping 12 laps sooner than the car should be. Which is risky because, well, going by what others have said, boost 3 can blow your lump. So he's taking a big risk doing that.
Yeah, I used to have that problem always when I tried to push. I was using boost 2 and I wanted to push from my last fuel I had that I know my tires could handle it. I put boost 3 and after like 2 laps my engine just blew up.
Yep. No, that's just your driving.
Nah.
It's you don't because like it shiny pumped you off.
It was a Ford, so
Shane just pumped you out of the way. He did it in testing. Yeah, he did it in testing. There's me and him going round, you know, he's following me. And then I was following him and he made a mistake. Got past him and then going through Maggots and Beckett, he slid in four wheels, I started sliding mid-corner, and he just whacked me on the strut of the rectum and off I went into the wall and lost my bonnet. Yeah, he's a crafty bugger, he's shown. Can't be trusted. Oh, hang on, we got another pit, that's which we called, didn't they, and then the ones that we said pitted earlier. Wondering whether they better disconnect. Let's quickly jump to their car. Let's have a quick looky. Oh, it's just a pit stop then. Yeah, no. Huh.
very.
No, yeah, because it's Wychwood and Wychwood Cole, that's why. So it's both their cars are stopping early, and I would have assumed they would. Nico wants me. No, I'll be back in a second.
Okay.
What's up? Oh, hang on, I'm still in the wrong room here.
Oh my god. So, let's check for any decent battles so far. In position 7. There we go. This is the... Let me check if that's... No, that's not right. Oh no, it is. It is the closest battle at front at the moment. Ooh, someone else is in the pits. Okay, these guys are clearly running boost on boost 3.
Right, we're back. Just an interesting little chat there with concerning pitch strategy. Something's yeah, come to light and I'm not telling you.
Oh, well, I can't. I don't know. Oh,
well, I can't say because the other team's listening.
Oh, yeah, I have to stop you.
I'll tell
you. Talk.
Yeah,
it makes me lag.
Telling me, I'll type in.
So you know a dirty secret.
Yeah, I know lots of dirty secrets.
It sounds good.
Try that again. There we go, that's better. There.
That's interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it could change the game a bit in our favour. We're up to 23rd, so... Yeah. This could get interesting.
Yeah, whatever Lutz told you about push to talk, it doesn't work.
Aye?
I still have the problems making the stream laggy or something when I push.
Yeah, that's why I just use open mic. Saves all the hassle. Not that it's
yeah.
When you're using the control button to push to talk, it goes in.
Ooh, and maximum it gets told wrong there.
It does something to the stream PC.
Yeah,
so
if I push, you get like 5 frames. If I push it, look.
It don't do it to me, does it? I'm on a separate RRD to you.
Oh. Damn. Yeah, I can make it to like one second or so. Crazy.
Yeah, that's why I just use another button. I'll just leave it on open mic, so you don't keep pushing things.
No, I'm using another button. I'm using 0 as a talk button.
Strange. Something going on there, who's that? Since Wychwood Call, where are you? There.
Where the huge train.
Where are you going?
Of course.
That's not it. There, try that. As soon as I spotted something going on here a minute, here we go. These two have been going at it for a couple of laps now. And Carson, oh, hang about, oh. Carson's pitted. Have a guess who's in the lead.
Marriott?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yep, Marriott is in the lead. We've got Carson's pitted. We've got Wilgrave have pitted. RML are in the pits. Independent Sim Racer GT1 have pitted. OnlineMotorsport.com have pitted. And X Factor Racing 3 are in the pits. So, Carson stopped. We're on lap 25, so the fuel's going down a lot quicker then. Because I know Nico's about to come in as well, so I need to announce that he's running Boost 1. So the fuel's going nowhere near where it should be. It's a 32 laps it's supposed to do. That's a massive shortfall. I wonder what's going on there. It seems to be everyone having the same issue, so it's not one car only, but it seems strange that that's the case. It wasn't doing that in testing. Track temperature's 27. We're almost done our first hour of racing. 2 minutes time.
Oh, we've done an hour already.
Yeah, coming up to it in 2 minutes. And we've now got Sebastian's in the pits as well for Independent Sim Racer GT2. I wonder if Mr. Ronnie Hannah will come in the car. That's weird though, we're going on with three wide, obviously, that's completely bewildered me.
Okay, I'll grab some quick munchies. Sorry, I can't resist.
Oh dear, oh dear.
You can eat when you're driving.
Oh yeah. The driving ain't hard enough, I've got to drive around eating and all. I'm alright, I'm not hungry.
I'm not hungry.
I'm not organic.
Yeah, you're just like drunk and you're gonna drive off everyone you see. Oh, somebody's hitting the pits there.
There we go.
Nico will pit for sure also.
That's the old broadcast car?
No.
What was going on there?
No idea. Yeah. It was like...
I've gone down to
black
two
stripes, look.
Yeah, look, there it is. What's the hell's happening here?
What's the black thing?
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of free FPS.
Yeah, I'm getting issues too.
Yeah, oh dear.
Nico, stop hacking. What the hell are you doing? That's not a Ferrari. It's something else in disguise.
Yeah, it is a Ferrari. Ferrari F1 car underneath. We're only using three gears at the moment. No, we're boiling.
Yeah, I was going to say that. We have some gear problems. That's why we're so slow.
Yeah, we're short shifting.
Oh my god, it's like the wheels are coming out for me.
Yeah, it's weird because
it's like a model, look, model.
What
glitch.
The hell's going on? Shane, what are you doing?
All the way, Shane. Okay, so give me like 5 minutes.
5 minutes? Oh dear, what are you doing? A gourmet meal?
3 minutes then? Steamed meat.
No,
you know that?
Let's see what you got to do.
No,
I'm
going
to have a message with Lips to see what's going on with this.
Oh yeah, I thought you were going to message him to get me fired. because I always go for food. Oh, this will be so mean.
And I've got the power to do that myself. I won't. I'll fire you after the 12 hours. Otherwise, I've got to do it on my own.
It's gonna be bad enough already to be here alone. With you, go on. He loses it when I just speak his name out. Oy, oy.
Oh,
poor old Nico.
What happened? I missed it.
That was like a commentator's curse.
We're all getting bad lag.
Oh, he's gonna pitch.
Lagging lot.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Come on, go inside.
The
there you go.
Right, we need
Look,
I'm gonna
I'll
have
go
to
grab
see.
something now, and you have no lag at all.
Let's try another car while we're watching. See, we haven't had the laser man haven't put an appearance yet today, so I'll pay them a visit. That's Marius Burke. There we go. They're now in last position, in 28th, but I do believe they stopped, so they should come back up again shortly.
Yeah, what's happened?
Both of us are getting frame rates dropping down to one, and we're getting the cars, the wheels look like they're about to fall off, and we're getting really big black streaks coming out of it. Like when you get the skid marks on the track, they're coming out the side of the car and going up into the air. And I can't work out why.
Works.
Yeah, it's alright for now. Seems to have gone back to normal. Yeah, do you know what's going on with Marius Burke? Because we can't understand what's happened.
Yeah, Marius has a disconnect, and this information also for... no, he has pressed escape, and here also the information for our English-speaking visitors and teams. The plugin will penalize the escape with a automatically rejoin. So you don't must leave the server. You can press escape and you will be disconnected, and then you can rejoin and go away, and you get no penalty.
No.
Okay.
So that's it, because we've got him as a temp car.
Yeah, the temp car is normal. Then in this moment, you do you have press race? In your wait, let me look. Oh no, D is crashed. No. Now you should never seen. Temp cars.
Right, see, there he is. Temp car.
Okay. Okay, then we won't make a short break. But not. So, sorry guys. We are back in 1 minute. And Wayne, Mr. Super Wayne will make radio now.
Nothing's changed at the minute. It's still, according to this, Marius Burke's leading, Carson's in second, but Carson has pitted, Marius is still yet to pit. So, and we've got Mr. Piccolo's worked his way up into fourth position, so he's doing well. Trying to see where did they go? Because they was doing well earlier. Where it? Ooh! I think Sebastian's had a disconnect. Because they was in 4th place and they pitted. And he's now in 27th position, so I'm wondering whether Independent Sim Racer GT2 may have disconnected as well. That's interesting. We'll get Lutz to look into that in a minute, because he's got more information available than I do.
Okay, now it After the rejoin, you will see all cars with normal viewing.
Yeah.
If you have this problem once more, please leave the game, complete, and start restart. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So, we go back to track and have fun, guys.
Yep, thank you very much.
Please note that the affector window is not inactive. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, guys, have fun.
Yep, and you. Right, we're back in action, so let's go and have a look at Mr. Sebastian Raven. He's in 25th position. I'm wondering whether they did definitely have a disconnect. We've got a few drivers here being shown blue flags. It's a free blue flag and then it's a drive-through penalty. The new system they're bringing in due to a lot of teams not seeing them before, so it comes up now, lets us know how many warnings they get. Once you've let the car pass, it resets itself, so we've now got Sebastian's on two blue flags at the minute. Now it's gone back again, so it's all a bit of something getting used to for some of the teams. Obviously it's a problem you get because we use the the practice sessions of running. You don't get blue flags in the same sense you would in race mode. So it's basically down to you have a team spotter that's watching the timing that we watch, that can inform their drivers of people that are giving them blue flags. It's obviously because you don't know whether you're racing that person or not. It causes some people to think that they might be racing that person and they're blocking and going defensive and stuff, and it's caused quite a few headaches for some of the leading drivers not being able to get past as easily as they would like, which is costing them race positions at the end of the race. So this is something now that's been looked into and they've improved it with a blue flag system for the race spotters to see. You've got your top 10 is Free Wide Motorsport. Second position is X Factor Racing 1. Third position is All-Star Racing Team 2. Fourth position is X-Factor Racing Team 2. Fifth is RML Racing Team 1. Sixth is Wychwood. Seventh is RSR Gaming Team 1. Eighth position is GP Racing Team. Ninth position is X-Factor Racing Team 3. So they've moved up. Then tenth position is RTM Racing. Let's have a jump on with... It should be Online Motorsports, and they are currently sitting in 18th position. Trying to see if we've got any battles going on at the minute. Oh, here we go, what we got going on here. This is a battle for 5th and 4th place. RML and X Factor Racing 2 should be. So, oh, we seem to have Sebastian's got back up there now, has he? No, they're being lapped, that's what that's to do with. And anyone that's interested, Nico is currently sitting in 23rd position for the broadcast team. We've completed 32 laps. And we've had, as far as I can tell, two disconnects, but one's a definite, which is Marius, who's managed to get up into the lead, but it's still showing him there's no pit stops yet, but because they've disconnected and come back on, he won't stop for some time yet, because he would have come on with a full tank again, so probably another 10 laps maybe before we'll see Marius in the pit. And he's got a 34 second gap, and I think the average stop's about 50 seconds, so Carson should definitely take the lead back. I mean, Marius looking at this will go to around 3rd place. Depends on how much time he makes between now and then. Now, these two are the closest battle. There's not much overtaking going on. And we've got one going there. Let's see, still got these two battling with each other. It's an ongoing saga now for a good 15 laps or so now. We're not making much headway. This is, as a driver, really, when it's frustrating. You're lapping more or less the same sort of lap times as a person and that you're chasing. You know, you can't make much time up and they're not pulling away from you, and after so many laps it tends to cause you to push a lot harder, which is something that we've seen now, because obviously Alex Piccolo went a bit wide and it's costing time now, and we've got cars all over the shop trying to get out of the way. It's been a bit brave move here, as we saw. It's a risky place to be pulling anything into the fourth gear corner. If he can stick with him, he may well be able to do him on the Willington straight, outbraking, going into the old Silverstone complex. We may well see a change of position this time, though. It depends whether Alex can build up that gap again. He's going, looking to go defensive. I think he's going to do it on the brakes, as you know, he's shut the door. Is bringing in other players to the game now, as we've now got following. We've got Daniel Storfens and Daniel Hacker now are looking like they want to join them with this car, so we know that they're two reasonably quick drivers. We'll see what the outcome of this will be. I think Mr. Sven's going to have to do something before long. Seems that Mr. Scorpion has fallen back a bit there towards Mr. Hacker. So we could well see a change there for position as well. This is your best battle at the minute going on the track. And Marius Burke getting his name for position.
Somebody lost the tyre.
Welcome back to the car club presenter.
Yeah, it were people from McLaren, so that's why it took so long. Can't blame them.
Yeah, no, the issue's fixed, and we have got Marius's cars back here. Who we had to reset the
people going.
There was a game reset.
Yeah, only on our end, just the Vorpal server.
Oh.
Logged out and logged back into it. Because it wasn't loading his car, but yeah, it was confirmed that Marius did have a disconnect. They only escaped back to the pits, but they didn't escape out of going, so... And by looking at it, you also missed... if it was right, Sebastian Rowan had a disconnect, but I'm not so sure because it's... He went down to dead last, but he's back up in fifth place now, so I don't know whether that's my tournament screens playing silly buggers, which it tends to do most races. Yeah, so Marius Burke's now in third place after he's just had his first stop. Carson's still leading. With All-Star Racing Team 2 and Michael Ritter in second position. X-Factor Racing 2 are in fourth now. Independent Sim Racing GP 2 are in fifth. RML Racing Team 1 are sixth, Witchwood are seventh. All-Star Gaming Team 1 are eighth. X-Factor Racing Team 3 are ninth. And GP Racing Team are in 10th. I'm going to just have a quick check-in with Nico, make sure everything's going according to plan.
Okay. You see Mary's birds, the temp car seems to be fixed after I was eating, so I surely missed a few things there. But we will try to keep you as updated as possible. Cross gets a little bit tricky on the exit, but he seems to hold it. Apologies if I sound a little bit weird, but I'm getting a little bit sick, I think. I should blame Shane and Wayne for that, but oh well.
We've had our plan that we thought might work for the pit strategy hasn't worked. It's actually costing us time now.
Ouch. They went over the cliff.
Yeah, to the tune of the 7.5 a lap. White.
I missed who that was, but it was surely somebody behind Sebastian. I don't see any position swap.
No, I mean, yeah, there's no... challenges, although it's the same thing in that midfield that Alex Kittler, Daniel Schwarfenz, and Daniel Hatton spent. So Sven's gone back, I think. Alex Kittler, yeah, Daniel Schwarfenz and Daniel Hatton have passed it. That's the biggest battle going on between those four for 7th to 10th positions. So, poor old Mr. Sven's gone from behind Alex and out the back of that train. But yeah, no, so we've got to change
Oh, well, those coffins are they touch, they go
steady
off.
On, steady on.
Oh no. That was so not necessary.
No, that was completely ridiculous driving behaviour there.
That launch was very delayed.
Seems they're back going how they were. Be interesting to see what the steward's decision on that one will be.
Yeah, that was too aggressive and too late.
Well, should have taken a wheel off of each car driving like that, could have put them both down to the back of the grid even.
Seems it's not much of a big damage, but it was nice. We have to be real for that.
We'll soon see. Let's go. Right button and we'll watch, see what his steering wheel's doing in respective to the car. Damage might only be cosmetic, hopefully. Yeah, we could have cost each other a wheel driving like that. It's just ridiculous.
It seems a little bit, it's just not much.
No, I should be getting in the car with that time.
Are you starting to get nervous?
Not really. I don't know what to do. Oh, I'm moving to the right way too.
Oh, Scofenza dropped back, so something happened again with Scofenza. He's behind.
Could have made the input damage. Which, rightly so, because he was the one that made the lunge, so if he had damaged his car, you know, it's just desserts on that one, I'm afraid. But yeah, no, Osha, get in there, but we're going to change a couple of two or three things in the car. We've discovered there's a strategy that we decided to go with just then at the last stop. It's costing us, we're lacking in the 205 at the moment, so we've got about a second and a half off the pace of what we wanted to be on.
Oh, we have a problem.
We have a crash, so...
We'll try to get that sorted for you as soon as possible, of course.
So we're back to doing a radio broadcast. We've got RML Team Racing Team 2 have pitted. They're in at the minute. It's weird, of all the teams that keep getting disconnected, it's always us. Well, what are you pressing? You're push to talk. Oh, crap. Alright. Oh, what? What's happened here? Doodles. Alright, 1 second. Need to get the IP. You typing in there, you'll push the blooming tonks, lost me my IP, you donut. Oh, hang on, where's my pen?
Yeah, that's my problem.
Yeah, it was you. You popped your push to talk, you.
Yeah.
Wally breath.
I didn't know I had the screen open. I thought it was open on the live timings. And yeah, I was just pushing to talk and I pressed zero. Silly me.
Yeah, she just can't get this stuff. Well, you get paid €1,000 an hour and this is how you behave. Dock your wages. Right.
I blame Shane.
Yeah, that's what I was just about to say. Let's blame him.
Well, the gap between Corriston and Michael, even after the pit stop, still is around 5.5 seconds, so he's really keeping the pace up there. Marius following in third position on around 17.5 seconds. Behind Marius is Akim Cross in fourth position. He's another 5.6 seconds behind. And then we have the battle between Akeem Cross and Sebastian, which is still within a second, which we will try to show you as soon as Wayne figured out how to fix it.
Yeah, it's everyone, not going well.
So everyone started blaming Wayne and started swearing.
Yeah, it ain't me, it was pressing buttons.
Well, it's your fault the game crashed.
Yeah, as always. That's it. Blame me, the one that's fixing it.
Yeah, because I don't know how to fix it. Well, I do know, but I will know now.
Yes. By the time we get back on, the race will be finished.
Then I blame you for sure.
Right, yeah. What an absolute nightmare.
Alex Piccolo in 8, and Daniel Hake, Sven Dreyer, and Daniel Kufienza are still way up close to each other. The gap between each of them is still 7 tenths. So that's really still, it's still a 4-way battle. And Wayne's struggling to fix it. He forgot the double dots.
Oh, not how to fix it. It's just not working.
You forget the double dots.
No, I did the double dot.
No, you didn't.
Oh, did you? No.
Now you're doing it again.
Two. See, the double dot should be there.
No, it's not.
Why is it not? What about now?
No. Let me do
right,
it.
Press your double dot because mine ain't working. Then.
Okay.
Are any of the dots working?
Uh-oh. Wait. What the fuck is that? I didn't do anything.
Right, just delete it. Start. Right, I'll give you what you need.
Okay.
And then type it in. Oh, this is brilliant fun.
That was totally unexpected.
See, we would actually be watching this now if you hadn't had your push to talk to this. Is what I say. Okay, I want push to talk. No. See, push to talk my barrier.
Well, it's because people will say I have echo if I don't use push to talk.
Well, you ain't got a brain, so don't worry about the echo. Right, there you go. Try that till you get on. Have we got anything happening? No, we're still pretty much where we left it.
Isn't that the IP if I just click it? I just clicked the bar.
That and it didn't work. Right, click connect.
Is it this?
Yeah, that's the one. No, see, it's not working because it should come up then.
Okay. Wait.
Right.
No. 58.
No, 85.
No.
Did I write it? It's 58 then. No, I did write it. It's 85. God, put your glasses on.
I have, you just forgot the dots.
Oh dear, comedy gold.
You can apologize to the people who are actually watching because you screwed up big time.
Yeah, I'm apologizing on your behalf. We've got a pit stop. Alex Piccolo's in the pits of Wychwood. Right, then you want the double dot.
It's not working.
What the hell then?
What did I put now?
I don't know, a lot of spaces. Right, hang on, I'll get looked.
I pushed the dot. Look. Why does it put space if I push dot? Ah, you killed it all. Can't you search in the list or something?
No, the list ain't working. Matchmaker's been down for like 2 days.
Oh yeah, right. Forgot about that. God damn it, Wayne.
No, this is all you're doing.
If Shane was here, this would never have happened. We only had lag.
Right,
you're so
I've
gonna get fired.
Him. Yeah, I'm gonna get fired because of you, you useless turd. Oh dear. I don't get why it's not working, like the double dock button ain't working for either of us.
Yeah, it's weird.
I really don't get that whatsoever. Is that you doing that?
Yeah.
No.
It's because the double dot doesn't work. Why does it make spaces? That doesn't make any sense.
That's completely hurts. Yeah, another that's the second time today I've been bewildered. Doing well. It's only just gone midday.
Well,
so if anyone out there is looking for a job in commentating that doesn't use push-to-talk, interferes with an IP address, there's a position going to shortly.
Oh, that's so nice.
Preferably someone that doesn't spend half a broadcast eating.
No, I'm trying to fix it and you're just like laughing with me.
Because I know you can't fix it because you're getting exactly the same results I am.
So, excuse me. What you can press, you can't control. Don't control
yeah, you know,
the
you
game.
Put the, you put the RC in and then the port. You have to put the double dots in. And you press shift on it.
You
it's
have
not
to,
worked for me or Dimitri.
Sorry. Dimitri, please mute your microphone. You have a echo.
Okay.
So, Wayne, repeat, please.
Right. You know when you put before you put the port number in, you have to do the double colon or whatever it is. The button before the after the L button. It's not putting it in when we're pressing it. It's not coming up.
Right. Ah, okay.
Yeah, see, the IP was there, but
yeah,
as we went to reconnect,
wait.
Dimitri pressed his push-to-talk button and it deleted the IP.
Yeah. Heh? okay, I must go... I'm just to see who is. But it's. Ah, you have set a point, no double point.
Yeah, that's what we can't put.
Ah, okay, yeah.
Yeah, the button's not working for both of us.
Sorry.
It's weird. Was it working for you and not for me and Dimitri then?
This is wrong. Okay, guys.
There we go. Thank
That's
you.
It. Thank you very much.
Yep. You're welcome.
Hey. Right.
I guess he has a special keyboard or something.
No, it's just us two. We're retarded. Right. Get out. Get. Right, here we go. Oh, hang on. Flipping out. Here we go. Right, there you go, we've got pictures again. Hey!
Thank God!
There we go, right. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, Dimitri's definitely getting sacked.
What? It wasn't me. You weren't able to put double dots.
It's as soon as I went onto that, right? The IP was there, and all of a sudden all these own W's and everything started to move. And then that's it. And then it was just, it wouldn't come back then, see? You're just useless. Shane, come on, you as well do it, man. Even if you're not speaking, you can't be doing a worse job than this plump. You do know with all this now, you'll be lucky to get a job in radio.
I'll try to fix the push the thing. I'm tired of it. Who puts his push the talk on zero anyway?
You did.
Yeah,
you'd
I know.
Be better off plugging your wheel in and sticking that next to you. And using a button on your steering wheel, because then it won't interfere with any inputs that you need to write something.
Yeah, but I don't have my steering wheel here, so...
And you're still not picked out yet?
I live alone, but I don't have a place to put my race setup in here.
It's just too small. Rid of your bed.
Yeah, and I'll sleep, eat, and fuck in my...
Language, Timothy.
My excuses. No, but it was just a matter, of meaning, or how do you say it?
I think the word you're looking for is entertain.
No.
Entertain the ladies is the word you're looking for. X-Factor Racing 2's in the pitch, whilst we get the new version of, can't remember the name of it now. What's that blooming book that all them women were reading? Now, 50 Shades of Dementia, you know.
Oh, God, no. It's that 50 Shades of Grey stuff.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, 50 Shades of Dementia.
we even have it in Dutch.
Well, I learned something from it, though.
How to talk to a woman?
No.
I
was on an aeroplane with my girlfriend, and she had it in her bag, and I said, "We ain't reading that," and she said, "Well, you should read it, you might learn something." So I did, I read the first two chapters, and then realised that it's against the law to masturbate in an aeroplane. Right, start setting my wheel and everything up now. Get me racing overalls on.
Yeah, I hope you crash, really. that would be just too mean for our team. But on the other hand, you just screwed us over. You couldn't fix it. Shane wasn't even that dramatical. He just lagged the broadcast and nothing bad ever happened.
Cool, it always happens.
We just get
rid
of Shane.
We've never managed yet to have one broadcast where we haven't had to get Lutz to fix something.
Really?
Yeah.
Because it's all your fault. Every time,
well, I'm starting to believe it must be me, because it can't just be Shane, because he's not even here.
Yeah, and I messed something out too, because I didn't even know.
Still your fault, you press the zero button. Aww. That's in the way, man. Oh, nothing's never simple. Despite what that speaking cretin says. Oh, no, we keep commentating and I'll get ready.
Alright.
Stress this is, man.
There's no need for stress.
No, not on your part, no.
I already have stress every time I have to talk. Oh my god, something. Oh my god, it crashed again.
Oh, for God's sake, what are you doing?
Nothing.
turned me back for 5 seconds and you busted it.
No, I put it back on fire already.
Right, now don't press your zero button.
I know, I have auto activation on. This is bad.
I can't believe we've been chucked off already.
Yeah. Why does it
only
keep crashing?
Been doing it for 10 minutes. Well, I don't know. There's got to be something going on.
Man, it didn't happen before. Maybe we're not...
Nothing.
Maybe we're
nothing
not
we're
synced.
Doing. No, this Lutz does this before. There's been no syncs today. He never does it on the day, and these are the servers are the first to get done.
Yeah, I was just trying to go on board with... how do I spell his name? Ah, Sascha Sigurd. And then all of a sudden the game crashed.
I ain't got time for this.
Oof.
Oh, poor old Nico, he's going to end up doing a triple stint. All right, I'm going.
Oh yeah, PM me. Oh no.
It's all in there.
Yeah.
Yes. Hi, oh, Jesus Christ.
It's all your fault.
Oh, hang on.
I'm blaming you. It's all your fault.
Nico's messaging me now. Oh. Right.
Yeah, I got it.
Right, you do what you need to do.
There we go.
Oh, what's going on? What the hell?
I'm clicking. I was already clicking and you were clicking it away.
Right,
see,
I've got to go.
It's all your fault.
I've got to go freaking it up.
Alright. Just leave it to me. Okay. So we're back again. Within 5 minutes having double problems already with the live stream. Crashing out on us and not able to connect back with certain IP because we couldn't put any double dots, but that's fixed for now. So we're gonna take you up to the closest battle at the moment, which is... Oh, something happened. We missed something. Right now, just give me one moment. Oh, okay, here we go. Let's just hope it doesn't crash again. Let's see, there's someone swapping position. Oh, I see. Somebody disconnected. Yeah. It's a pit stop or a disconnect. I will have to check that. There we go. Yep, it's a pit stop. Going again, so that seems flawless. quick run over on the top 10. We have Karsten Wilm still leading this race for GRL XF Racing 1 on first position. On second position, we still have, the gap's gone up a little bit to 8 seconds, but we still have Michael Reuter on second position. And for third, we have Three White Motorsports with Marius Birds following behind on another 12 seconds. The gaps are really starting to come open for now, and in the top 5 at least. On fourth, we have Sebastian Roan, who's behind on another 14 seconds from third placeman Marius Bird. On fifth, we have Ben Dreyer, who's just following not that far behind. And on sixth, we have Daniel Heike for the other GRL FX Racing crew. He's on sixth. There we go. He's right behind. He's not that far behind, actually. So this is where the battle is actually still alive. On seventh, we have Michael Kallenbach. I don't know if I pronounced that right, but I hope so if I did. And he's getting hounded by Sascha Siret, who's right behind on 8th position. On 9th, we have David Putzke, who's a little way behind, who's driving kinda lonely at the moment. And rounding out the top 10 is Dirk Sutter for Wellgrave Motorsports. Oh, there we go. Camera didn't really want to work with me, so please bear with me. So we're gonna take you back to the battle. There we go. Let's go on board with Sascha Siret. Michael is getting very tail happy there. Look at that, Z4 looking way, much more stable there. Going through up for the straight. Just a little off for slipstream, I believe. No, not that much. Getting closer. Look at that braking, very late. We'll probably see some cars spinning in the front soon with Wayne taking over the wheel. I hope he's gonna have some good stints and some fun at least. But he can give us a quick interview about his 2-hour stint, which he will take over from Nico de Koning, who will soon be in the commentary with me. Even so, if you have any questions or want to be interviewed here on the broadcast with me, you can contact us on the broadcast team on Facebook or just send me a message on TeamSpeak and I'll try to get in touch with you and get you in for an interview. Yeah. So it happened before with Confianza, right, moved on Alex Pro, I believe it was, and he got it all wrong there, so good driving and be really patient there. It's an end race, after all, it's not a sprint race. There we go, he's gonna look out here on the right side, no, he's gonna stick behind. Oh, he's really, really getting close. There. Very late on the brakes, brake stuff. What was that appearing behind? Is that also for position? Let me check. No, it's not. Wait, it is. That's weird. That's still a large gap, 20 seconds. I was just checking if it was right or not. Because the life timing sometimes does agree to be a pain in the butt and not show us the real life timings. We're gonna go back to Sasha and Michael, because they are the real closest at the moment. Here we go. Come on, camera, move. If you want, at least. Oh, there we go. Come on board, look at that. Harsh on the brakes. Look at how more dedicated he comes through the corners. It's like more stable. It's like he has more time. Oh, and he goes too wide over the curb and nearly loses it. Oh, that was a little bit too brave. Dearie me. Well, that fight is over for now, but we know he's quick and he will need a lap or two to get back in that slipstream again and just try it again. Let's see, who else do we have? Oh, for place 5. There we go. Now. My, why are the life timings going through each other? Just gave me the same battle. It's the only closest battle with just less than a second. A few more, but yeah, the gap's just 2 seconds half. Further on, out of the top 10. There we go. Gonna check it real quick. There we go. That should be 2.5 seconds. A little bit less, if I can, or if I may believe. Our man who had our latest pit stop, or maybe I missed others, I don't know. I'm currently looking alone at everything on a tiny, tiny screen. There's in fact 3 people in the pit. What, 5th and 6th position that was? Go to some camera action. There we go. 2 people in the pit stops. And that's Sebastian Roan, Michael Kalembe, and Sven Dreyros should also be in. That's Sebastian left already. He's going. Seems a long pit stop. Again, up on the track. Everyone should have done their normal 2 pit stops around, I believe. Just Marius Bird and Sasha Siegert was running second now, still have 2 pits for their second stop, so shouldn't be that much longer. There we go. Marius still carries on. Same for Sasha, who actually got some little bit breathing space, so if he can make this lap work, he can make an undercut. Oh, and he's coming in right now. So he's gonna be battling with... I have to make sure I don't miss out now with all these drivers. Whoops. Yeah, I lost the man he was battling with, so I screwed up that one. Fresh tires going in. I think Wayne just died or something. He's not in yet. The car. Oh, he just got in the car. He's in the pits. There we go. That's a stressful commentator man who was here just like 5 minutes ago, who screwed up our broadcast with removing the dots, and he's currently on track. But we're gonna head back to Sebastian. Ronnie. There we go. Just behind Alex Piccolo. Yeah, he's not that far behind him. Alex Piccolo is actually also still close to Robin Haas. The battle for P5. That's not right. Well, this seems also to be a battle, if I'm not mistaken. No, it's not. It's just running through traffic. Getting lapped. Alrighty, back to the top 5. Camera's not always willing to work with me, so sorry for that. It's in fact even my first time I'm actually operating cameras, giving commentary, and trying to watch live timings. So yeah, that's an easy job, but my work should get a little bit lighter when Nico comes and joins me in to give me a little run through on how his stint went and what happened and stuff. But Nico still seems to be helping Wayne, and the battle is on with Ronnie. And the camera's not willing to work with me again. Just changing stuff. Okay. I'll cut you now. Oh, look at that, so close. Blue, back to Alex.
Hello.
Oh, hello, Nico just joined us when we were just watching the action with Ronnie Hanel trying to go outside of Alex Piccolo, but that didn't work. Ooh, dearie me, that was close. So, Nico, tell us, how did your stint actually went?
Well, I started quite okay. No spins, quite consistent lap times. And then I had a little spin, kept on racing. And then at pit stops we tried to double stint the tires, but in the end it didn't really pay out. And just gave the car to Wayne Reed and he tried to do his best and hopefully not crash.
Well, that was the first thing I said to him also, like, Nico's doing a good job keeping the car alive for a 2 hour stint, and now Wayne's gonna get it and most likely crashing out like broadcast recently. And Sebastian is going, Ronnie is going out to outside of Alex, and he's gonna make it stick. Yes, nice move. He did it. He's finally got past. A great move there. Yeah, as I was saying, Wayne crashed our live broadcast stream twice in like 5 minutes.
Oh yeah, I remember it.
He crashed, Air Factor stopped working, and he wanted to connect again, and I had push the talk button open. So I pressed 0 when he was entering the IP, and I had it also open. And it removed the whole IP, and we couldn't make any the double dots. It wasn't possible for us to put it in, so we had to call Lutz to fix it for us. And then, yeah, it got fixed, and like 2 minutes after us, the game started crashing again.
Oh, bad luck, but now it will be all fixed, hopefully.
Yeah, well, at the moment it seems stable, there's no lag. So, we're gonna keep our fingers crossed to that.
Knock on wood.
Wow, Ronnie's actually flying, he's just driving away from Alex. And in fact, he's only 2.5 seconds behind Robin Haase in 5th position. But that could be an upcoming battle. Okay, let me check first something. Out so he can make my life a little bit easier on commentating and hoping I don't miss the action while I'm doing this. And the game crashed again. Oh my god, idiot. I have to fix that first. Oh god. Why now?
Ow.
Hold on, Nico. Wait, somebody was talking. Oh my god. Whoever was talking to me, please send me a private message, as I can't find you anywhere on the chats. I believe it was Maximilian. Yes, there we go. We should be back live in just a second. Trying to load this up as I do. Please work. There we go. And now there we go. It's loading back up, so we're gonna go back live.
That's good.
This always happens to me. Like, I'm just stressing out, trying to figure everything out on my first and alone occasion. And then just the game crashes as I'm trying to help you out.
Oh, just...
That's not good.
We'll get there.
Oh yeah, no stress. My plane waits for everything. We have a battle here? I don't know. I just clicked a random camera, but I'm guessing that's the car from Daniel. Or was from Daniel. Let me check. Jörg Vogel. Yes, and that's a battle for position. So, I can keep you people entertained while I try to help Nico without the game crashing again. So he can help me. Dear me, stress level 100. Okay. That's a problem. I have no idea how Wayne gave it to me.
Okay,
oh my god. Oh god, they did it again. This is weird. It keeps crashing. I'm not doing even anything. Try to send a message to Lutz about the RRD viewer, to get it. And tell him the game keeps crashing randomly. I don't know why, but it just does. I'll try to relaunch that. It's curious, because we didn't have these problems before. If we had problems before, it was all Shane, and it was all just lagging a bit, but not just random game crashes. But, oh well, it can crash as many times as it wants. I'm not gonna give up. It's still a long way to go, it's still 10 hours to go, a bit over 10 hours.
No, it's definitely a long way, but and still a lot of things can happen. As we saw that various net disconnected in the first 20 minutes, so...
Yeah, and it was a real, really weird one. It was like he disconnected, but he got back, like, instantly and just took over the lead. Just for a while, though, but it's not like he lost a lot of ground, at least.
Yeah, at the moment he is leading, so...
It's really he's still leading.
Yeah, I wonder how he did it, because...
Yeah, but he still has to pit. Yeah, he does. He still has to pit. He's the only guy who did one pit stop together with Carson Fisher for LML Racing, but he's in driving in position 20 at the moment.
But both of them had a disconnect.
Oh. Well, it's still weird that... Normally should lose a lot of time, should even be lapped or something. But, oh well, we're back live, and during a quick few unnoticed battle that I will try to bring on to you at the moment. It's still for 5th place. There we go.
Yeah, they seem to be really close.
Yeah, three-way battle. But Alex just following, about 3 seconds behind. Now we see him in the background, going through the chicanes. Well, can't really call them chicanes, just going flat out, I guess, and just clicking one back from fifth to fourth, I believe.
Now, you enter the first left full throttle. Some people brake slightly, others just lift off and shift down once. Then they brake and shift down another one for the second left. And I don't know if they stay in fourth or drop down to third for the right-hander.
Oh well, that's surely something nice to know, because we see, yeah, some people going, it's like they're really attacking it, and other people are trying to take it smoothly, just more calm and perceptive way or something.
Yeah.
Like we saw, if Karsten just goes through them, it's like he's flying, he's just riding the curves real smooth. It's just like he did it for years before. It's just crazy to watch.
Yeah, we take a lot of it on those corners, but...
Alright, so I'm gonna try again now to help you. Or life timings. There we go, but that's something you probably already have.
Yep. Well, I think I'm good to go. I can follow the time, so...
You still have other viewer.
No, position 12 and 11 seem to be quite close too.
Let me check that. Position 11 and 12.
Gabor Spielmann and Jörg Bogel.
And if you want to watch, you can always follow the live stream. Will only be just like 5 second delay or so, I don't know. Oh yes, this is a really close battle between both Audi drivers. Yeah, that was a battle that was raging before, but Jörg seemed to pass. Yeah, that was the occasion also in qualifying, where we saw a few people just going ridiculously over the curbs, just not on the curbs, just totally over them. I think the penalties were right place. As we see, Sim Racing for Holland going in the pits probably for a third stop. And I don't think there's any need for a driver change yet, because we saw Dennis Dona before on the car.
Yeah, I think he's gonna start his second as Ivanov started the race. I remember that he...
Ooh, and a lazy man racing disconnected. That's something I also missed.
Yeah, that happened about an hour ago, something. No, a little bit less, but...
I don't know, it's... My life timing still says disconnected, and I don't think doesn't seem they're coming back, because they still are on lap 41, and the current lead lap is on 62, so that's over 20 laps difference, so that's DNF for them.
No, I think they were doing quite a good job, and driving within the top, maybe top 15, and disconnected and never came back.
Ooh, I believe Wayne is in a battle. That looks interesting to watch. Jörg Vogel is just moving away from that battle. So we're gonna switch on to Wayne. There we go. He has an Audi right behind him. Let's see how he's gonna cope with that. Battle for a lost active position in the game, as of Lazy Man has retired on 28th position. So these are the final.
It's a battle with the new team of Flashbot Racing.
Yes, correctly. They're a new team since this race, I believe. I can't remember seeing that name on Daytona before and other events.
Yeah, it's a new team consisting out of three Dutchmen, then the Englishman who is driving, Greg Moore, and the Belgian Peter Noah. Although he isn't driving today because he is sick.
Oh. So we have Peter actually driving for Flatspot Racing now. Oh, that's something I didn't know.
Yeah, he decided it only last week, so...
Oh, I see. No, I thought he was driving for the broadcast team. But I guess... not.
No, he isn't anymore.
Well, Wayne seems to be able to keep up the gap between them, so I'm gonna check if there's any more important battles for the top spots. Check. Ooh, yep, we have one for position 7 and 8, if I'm not mistaken. Or 8 and 9 at least. Oh my god, my race timing's jumping crazy.
Well, the places between 2 and 7 seem to be all close.
We have Alex Piccolo, Brown Deck, and just a little bit behind, we see Luigi Russo on the Audi, and just behind him we have Sascha Schigert, who has been quite battling the whole race already. Good stuff from him. And Alex Piccolo was the one who got collected at the start of the race by... I have to check for his name again, I just forgot it. Scufianzo, I think it was.
Oh, Daniel Scufianzo.
Scufianza. And it's really hard to keep it in mind how it's pronounced. And we saw Alex Piccolo diving into pit lane while I was trying to pronounce somebody's name.
Yeah, it seems to be that quite a lot of people are on the same strategy, and it seems to be that there's a group of people that pit like 5 laps before the second group, and then there are a few people who pit another 2-3 laps later.
Yes, I know what you're meaning. It's just like some people do 14 laps or so, just an example, and they're like 4 people doing 14 laps then pit. Some people will be more tire friendly and fuel friendly, but still being able to consistent, and they'll just make the difference about just staying a little bit longer out.
I think the difference is really gonna lay in with what boost they are driving on, because I don't see how.
No, I think if you are constantly driving around 3 or 2 and somebody's driving on 1 also, I think, I can't really be sure about Marius because of his disconnect, but he was the one to be able to stay out for real long. And actually the broadcast team only has one pit stop still. So I don't know if that's right. According to the live timings, it says one pit stop. I'm guessing it should be 2.
Yeah.
And we see Brown flashing his lights. I have no idea why he did that. I wasn't really paying attention. As I was trying to understand, he's just trying to navigate to traffic to let him know he's coming and he wants to get by easily and quickly. And we see Marius, where he is. Oh, there he is. He's in third position after a disconnect and a pit stop. Still no driver swap yet. So
I
we
think
saw the first man swapping position with Karsten changing with Peter Grau. We also have Andrea Schmidt now in second position. They have did a driver swap, but Marius is still going. I think he just wants to build a gap or something, I don't know.
I think they may go, that they may opt for a 3 stint a person, and would mean that everybody has to drive the car once in a row, so that they don't have to drive, stop and drive again.
Yeah, that could be a reason, but I don't know why you would risk of doing just a 3-hour stint each person. I mean, I did an endurance before, but I had like a stint of 1 hour and a half already, and I just think that was a little bit long to 2 hours, that would be too much for me.
I think they are quite...
No, see?
I think they're quite confident of the drivers. You know, if you see to all the people that drive here, many of the front runners are really capable of doing extraordinary things. If you see what lap times they can run consistently over 2 hours, it's immense. So, I think they can pull it off, and that's why they're doing it also.
That's the key. Oh, and Sasha just had like a big moment coming out of the final turn. He had like, I don't know, it was like snapping the steer or whatever. The car just acts really weird there. I just had a bad view to see what happened actually there, but
I think he may have been right. Gotten a bit of oversteer as corrected and the opposite direction.
That's what I meant, oversteer. I said understeer probably. Yeah, but it was really weird. It was just like totally unexpected. And it dropped him down a bit. At least a half a second has been lost there. But we saw it before with Sasha. He's a fast guy. He made a few mistakes already, but he's being able to close up the gap again and to give us some action to watch and to commentate on. So really nice going for him, and a lot of cheers. Also, we didn't have any one of the drivers or team bosses or whoever wants to join us in, or I don't know, to say hello or for an interview or to want to talk about your team or strategy or stuff, anything like that. You are free to welcome. You're welcome to join us. You can contact us on Facebook, or you can send me a private message via TeamSpeak if you're on your channel. Oh, no problem, everyone's welcome. And we are actually curious to have somebody in, because we always have so less people, and mostly till the near end of the race, then actually we see people coming in to have some talk because they get more relaxed over stuff. But oh well.
I can get why many don't really directly come into the boot, because now is the moment that you're watching other people when they pit. You try to make other things yourself. If you made any mistakes during testing, like if you miscalculated a bit of fuel, you try to adjust it to get the maximum out of your stints.
Of course, and not everyone is eager to actually tell what strategy their team on, because there's a lot of other people from, or supporters from teams, and even own drivers just watching the live stream most likely. So I don't think they would like to just come in and just tell them what their plan is with a race that's still more than 10 hours.
Yeah, they're all really good friends and stuff, but when it comes to the race, it's when it comes to the race itself, they're like real competitors. It's like we would almost bet that the millions behind this. It all costs money.
Yeah, but I know. It's really nice to see that on track they can be friendly and they can battle really hard. But just as soon as the race is done, and I noticed before, even if it is in German, I don't really understand everything 100%, but when they do the end of the driver briefing, everyone just comes together in one chat and they're all cheering and talking. They're just all friendly to each other. It's a really nice community. Yeah. I'm kind of impressed.
But I think we can say that the two real big top teams are the one of Carsten Willem and Sebastian Roen. And sometimes when I join the TeamSpeak server, I see Sebastian and Carsten in the same TeamSpeak and they're chatting together, and it's really nice to see that.
Yeah, and of course they are not from the same team, because Sebastian is driving for Independent Sim Racer GT2 with Ronnie Hanel as a teammate. And we all know Ronnie, he's a quick guy, and he's currently running smoothly in fourth, 13 seconds behind of the podium. And that will be Marius Bird, and we have a battle here. Like I said before, Sasha, he's a quick driver. He made a bit of mistakes already, but he's right under that wing again. And he's looking really hungry to get past. He's not giving up. He's closing the gap ever again and just trying to find a weak spot or just a little gap. Like, he's just checking out here, just taking a kickaboo there. Oh, and he's getting it smooth. He's going on a throttle, he's on the inside. No, he can't get it done. Just stick behind for the slipstream.
Yeah, and I think we can definitely say that Luigi is struggling a bit with defending. Especially in those corners where you have two right after each other. He defends the first one, but the second he's almost wider.
And here, Sasha should be quicker and much quicker than Mr. Rousseau.
And he might get a draft after the straight if he can't build up in the course.
He missed his apex there a bit. Not much work done, just a little time loss. But no biggie. Still there in that position. And he still wants to get past. He's at least 9 at the moment, but he could be looking about a lap or two for the 8th position. These guys have been battling like the whole race. Yeah, we can nearly see the whole race, except with little incident that Russo's teammate had. I believe that was this car. Yeah, it was. And no, he's doing another kickaboo. Well, again, apologies for the coughing. But I can't use push to talk anymore, else Lutz would probably kill me if I screw up something with the... Ooh, and he's going on the inside, he's stepping on the gas, but no, not yet. Maybe now. Ooh, he's going wide again over the curbs. That's the second time that happened. Dearie me, he really wants to get past. No need for stress, son. Still, we still have... yeah, a little less over 10 hours to go. Under 10 hours, I mean. And my voice is starting to die. Oh god, it's burning for hell. Apologies again for that.
Now, we must admit that this isn't an ideal situation to broadcast, but yeah, Shane can't help it to be sick, apparently, so.
Well,
all his fault.
Stuff like this always happens, and if it happens, it's always Shane.
Oh well,
we can't blame the poor guy forever.
No, that's true.
But oh well, Shane, if you're watching, and if you're feeling a little bit better, please come annoy us for a bit. I don't care. Come for a chat, or even if you're watching the race, come say your mind, what you think about the race so far. I have to be honest, I have to be stressing a lot about checking live timings, doing cameras, trying to do a bit of commentary. It's all a bit much for a first time, full time doing everything. But for what I've seen so far, this is a really good race. I don't know what you think about that, Nico. You probably didn't notice it that much by sitting in the car yourself, but...
Well, I did notice when I got lapped that there was a big pack of like 6-7 people together, and yeah, they can really... It seemed to be that they weren't attacking and stuff, but still it must be kind of bit of stressful. And I think we have a battle for 15th position. There's less than a 5 tenths between Philippe Noël and René Cooler from Online Motorsports against the RML Racing Team 3.
Oh, yeah, that could be right. I was gonna move real quick, but Sasha's really stepping on it. That BMW, he's really flooring it. He's really fast. if he can get past, let me check who's next on the list. This is for 8th position, so if he moves up, he's only 2.5 seconds behind Brown Deck.
I think those two might are catching him at the moment, because it seems to be that Sasha is pushing Luigi quite hard, so although they are battling, they seem to be going a little bit faster.
He's motivating the guy in front. He's not actually attacking, he's just peeking a little. Ooh, he's going to hold the tight line, stepping early on the gas. He's gonna be on the outside for the next quarter. Is this gonna be a clean pass? No, he's going back on the inside. Ooh,
he's gonna be on
right
the outside for the next one.
Oh, he's clipping the curb, defended his line, and Russo holds the position yet again.
Yeah, great defensive driving from him.
Yeah, he got a little bit of nervous, but that's normal when you have a guy with a BMW behind you, and he has been there for trying for like 10 laps, made 2 mistakes, but came back again. He knows the pace is there, he has to keep him behind, but he has to keep the car in a perfect state also, and not trying to make any big contacts or overdoing the tires, or else it could risk the whole strategy.
Well, I don't think the tires are really going to be a problem in this race. They seem to be going quite long, so it's going to be all to fuel strategy that this race is going to be won or lost.
Oh, and he's going in the inside again. He has a much better exit. And Sasha has the move done. Rousseau's going very wide. So I'm thinking he let him pass. Yeah, it looked like it. He knows it. He's too fast. If he defends the whole time, his tire's gonna die out pretty soon. So the only thing he can do is let him pass and just use him as a... I just lost the word for it.
Yeah, as a...
As a carrier or something. Yeah, I believe it's called a carrier. Something that pulls you to somewhere else.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the word I've been looking for. He can use it as a carrier to get it to Brown Decker, I believe it was, the man in front. So, if he can start to battle with him, we could see Russo back in a hunt for a three-way battle.
It's really something nice to have someone faster in front of you, and then if you just slightly faster is the best, because you can really get close to them and try to stick to them, and as you stay longer behind them, you get to follow their lines, their braking points, and makes yourself faster. But another nice thing is to see more and more different kind of cars. In the beginning of this series, we had only one BMW Z4 and no Lamborghini, and I think there are now 2 Z4s and 2 Lamborghinis, so it's nice to have a bit more diversity between the cars, although there are a lot of Audis and Ferraris.
Yeah, at the beginning there were like more Alpinas, and now there's like, I believe, only one left. There used to be another team driving an Alpina. I can't recall what team it was, but they seem all to be changing to Audis, and I don't know why.
Well, the Audi is quite a good car, but yeah, it's a bit sad in a way.
Ooh, he's running a little wide over the curb, yeah, and he lost his carrier. So, yeah, he's not gonna be able to pull that gap down together, but I'm gonna check for that battle for P15, you said. I don't know if the battle's still raging, but
I think
Racing
it is.
Association, yes, should be right. Not entirely sure, but I'm gonna... Oh, yeah, here we go.
Yeah, they're 6 tenths behind.
He's right behind it. There we go. Oh, now he got a slipstream. Is he going to make a move? He's going for the outside. braking late. Oh, he's going wide. Now, cut it back real soon. Not much time lost there. Ferrari looking really stable. If I watched how Karsten. Oh, and we have yet another problem. I don't know what happened, but we're still going live, I believe. Yep. Everything seems to be okay. We just had a little error popping up. I believe somebody who pitted and joined the server and didn't use SimSync. And indeed, there is somebody in the pits. And we gotta check if he's the guilty man.
Yeah, there we go. I hope for all teams that they really stress their drivers to sync before they join, because if they find out that the driver didn't sync or so, they will probably be disqualified from the race, and that would be a shame.
Oh, and my camera's flipping around. No, that's not the one I wanted, but okay, we will be able to fix that. Just give me 20 seconds, not even close. Yep, there we go. Come on, Mr. Camera. There we go. Back into action. I don't know what's going on, but most time my cameras aren't even working. So I'm trying to get a hold of them. There we go. What I wanted. You can see, the annoying NASCAR cams. Or the Daytona cameras, like Wayne, he actually loves this camera point. It always goes great when I do this. He's going for the slipstream. No, too soon, man. Wait, oh, he's gonna have a nice exit. Ooh, a little bit wider. Not looking like it's going to be this lap.
As long as he can stay close to the car in front, going into Magotson. Magotson might be able to get a good exit, and Magotson then get a good draft on the long straight. Oh, it seems to be that there was a car off in Beckett.
Something I missed. Trying to check live timings. We have Luigi Russo in the pits. Probably just for his second stint getting ready. I don't think it's gonna be a driver swap. No, he just left. Or that, or it's my live timings. So I'm freaking out again. But I'm gonna believe it.
Surprised me they would do a driver swap now. But
yeah, well, I was thinking they would do a driver swap, but well, I guess not. Not yet.
No, I think they're gonna do it. The next pit stop is gonna be a driver swap, because then he did a two stint, and doing one stints of one doesn't seem to be quite logic.
Gonna check a little bit into the top 10. It all still looks settled. We still have Peter Grau for GRLXF still leading the race. I can't really recall. Oh, there we go. We still have the gaps. With Andre Schmidt is still around, let us say, 8.6 seconds. So that gap isn't really getting much larger, but it's not coming down, so it takes a few laps, but the gap's building bit by bit. So good job from the GRLXF guys. They're doing an awesome job. And third position, we have Marius Wirth. who's actually catching them. Yeah, he's actually catching them. He's only 5 seconds behind anymore. And he has done the same amount of pit stops. So, yeah. I'll let you speak now, Nico. I'll finish later.
And it seems to be that Wayne Reed made up a position from VE Racing 1 with Hassan Bourdois behind the car. Not behind the wheel.
Yeah, that would be epic if we see him running behind his Corvette, like pushing it. Wow, that's kind of nice Corvette, though. First time he's on the live stream.
No, I think it's a car that it did well at Eastern Creek, I think.
Well, I like Corvettes, but they're not much used anymore. Well, except Sim Racing for Holland is using also a Corvette.
Yeah, it seems to be that they switched from their 4GT. It was a shame, yeah. Too, but
it's a nice looking car, but I think it's just there's something wrong. No, it's something wrong with the weight, I think. Yeah, I just think it has. Normally, it always has a disadvantage just with the weight on the rear tires. I think it eats tires. I didn't test it for like 20 minutes, but I did a test run once for Wayne. And they were just about to enter the 4GT, and I was like, whoa, I don't want to drive that car, really. I didn't like it, I didn't feel really, I don't know, comfortable with it. It felt nervous and it felt like it was trying to kill me. I like it when it's trying to kill you, but not for an endurance race. I can't handle a car 24 hours or so like that. That's just too risky.
Yeah, we had the same thing in Daytona. We drove the 4GT there and our setup wasn't good and we changed quite a lot of things but never got to what we wanted to, and halfway through the race we were really struggling to keep motivated and really keep concentration to keep the car on track, and we noticed that we were making more and more mistakes and decided, yeah, maybe it's just better to give up instead of driving in everybody else's way. And I think it was a right decision because we would have made a lot more mistakes. And it seems to be that the broadcast team car is spitting.
Yep. And we got him live in view. Wayne doing his very first pit stop. Simracing.org, I think. I don't think recall he drived before in this league. He's doing his very first pit stop. That's
and I would
he
say
just doesn't hit a garage or somebody of the pit crew. Oh look,
say
I see Shane. he's coming with cookies. Oh, that's so sweet. I'm happy Wayne can't hear it. But if Shane's watching, he's probably laughing his ass off right now. And somebody else in the pits, is that Peter Grau? I have to check. No, it's not Peter Grau. I can't recall. Oh, it's Jurk Vogel. Oh, he's pitting as well. He's in 8th position. Completed 77 laps. 3rd pit stop. And David Putzke is coming in also. Jens Puxka is also in the pits.
Yeah, it sounds about right. I gave the car to Wayne in a very busy period, and you know we're running slightly more fuel at the moment, so should be
okay. You seem to be running great compared for strategies. The car seems not to be eating its tires much more faster than somebody else, and we see somebody in the background flashing his lights there, letting him know there's a back. Oh, yeah.
Racing
for Holland coming through, and I think that was a battle for position with the Corvette. I believe it is. Not entirely sure.
It's a battle between the Corvette of
VE
Racing.
Yep, for 25th position. So Wayne got a little bit surprised there with that Corvette, probably thinking there's another leading group coming through.
I'll be right back.
Blue flag. And he just went out, yeah, a little bit wide off the throttle. There we go, like he does now. He's letting everyone through. Very nice. Ooh, that's not the place where you want to let somebody through or go in the brakes. Especially with these guys going full throttle and to the first two corners. Then just hitting one gear back. Left to fourth, to third. And off. So, after we saw that, he lost his man to battle with, and do we have more pitting cars? No, not at the moment. So, we only have one disconnect at the moment, and it was Lazy Man Racing on lap 41. We are currently on lap 78. We still have, well, we have some changes. Oh, we have some changes. That's not right. Did I miss? Oh, yeah. Nothing happened. Peter Grau pitted from the lead. So, we're gonna round up the top 10 right now. We have Marius Bird still, well, not still, but leading the race. After a weird disconnection issue, I don't know what's actually happened there. My friend Wayne should know more about that, but we have Ronnie Hannell in 2nd. He's 27 seconds behind, so Marius has a nice gap between him. On 3rd position we have Brown Deck. On 4th position we have Sasha Sears, the man who was battling many times before in the beginning of the race, but finally got some clean air. On 5th position we have Peter Grau from Gerald FX, that's our virtual leader at the moment since he has one extra more pit stop. On 6th position we have Ibo Spielmann. I don't know if I said that right, but it sounds like that. 7th position we have Andreas Schmidt. On 8th position we have Robin Hase. Those both of them only already did their 3rd stop, so they should be running a top 5 when the others pit. On 9th position we have Thomas Pasche. He's already did his 3rd stop also, so he should make some positions. And rounding out the top 10 we have Luigi Russo, the man who was trying to defend before from Sasha Sheard, so he's running out at the top 10 and he also did his 3rd pit stop. I don't know who just joined.
Ah,
hello.
That's me.
Ah, okay, you're back.
Yeah, I just got an update from Wayne and he had 3 spins during his stint apparently, and in one of them he brushed the wall and he didn't notice that he had a bit of damage and he lost about 10 seconds in the pit because of it.
Oh, so that's the why he was standing still for such a long period of time.
Yeah.
Oh, we have Ronnie Hannell who's actually in the pits. Pitting from 2nd position, Rocket Ronnie. Is he going for a driver swap?
No, I don't think
I
so.
I doubt it, but whoever knows. Brown Deck just came through, takes over 2nd position.
Although, isn't Ronnie for... is this his 3rd hour in the car?
No, Sebastian started the race. And okay. Ronnie took over from Sebastian, so we are currently 3 hours live in the race. I'm guessing Ronnie will do, or try to do, another long stint from at least, yeah, I could say another hour, maybe a bit longer. Like Marius, who has already been in the car for 3 hours without anyone else driving. Yeah, dear Jesus, for that. I wouldn't do that, but okay, if you can, why not? And Ronnie leaving the pits in position 7, getting some nice clean track in front of him. Yep, so he can get his tires up to temperature and start to make a gap. There we go. Yep, that was a nice clean track, but he has traffic behind, and that is for position. Umas Pashi, and there's someone else behind. It is Mr. Russo, who was just running up at the top 10 before. He moved up one position, and he's P9 at the moment. Alex Piccolo has now taken P10. And yeah, he's only 2.5 seconds behind, so we'll make that 3 seconds now. Not that much difference, but there you go, you can see him in the background there. While Russo is riding the curbs like a surfer, nice and tight, not going too wide, not trying to make any mistakes. At least he's the one hunting somebody else right now, so he doesn't have to mind about defending, because Alex is still 3 seconds clear. And they're doing consistent lap times, so not much panicking needed. Like there, he just came to say hello, to let him know he's here, I want to go through. Are you gonna give me an easy pass, or are you gonna make my life miserably and hard? And I think he already knows the answer to that. It's not gonna be an easy pass. These guys are all racers, so... Ooh, that was close. Like, I thought for a second that was a little nudge, but... didn't exactly see it. That clear. There we go. Behind the big badass Alpina, and he has a slipstream, he's much faster, and yeah, that's gonna be a clean move. There we go. Yeah, nothing much he can do about it. And through goes Russo, who can now start the hunt. Ronnie Hanel. Still, yeah, just 2.2 seconds in front. I didn't lose much time, but Russo is on fresh tires, so he should be flying at the moment. And Sasha Seert, actually, who has pitted, actually lost out to Mr. Russo. And Sasha rejoined on position 9, who has a battle with Brown Deck in the Lamborghini. So, still battles after 3 hours, still battles of 2, sometimes battles of 3, warming up here and there. And that's the way we want it. There we go. We got Alex Piccolo, Mr. Sasha Seert, who's actually also 3 hours in the car, I believe. That could be the reason why he made some mistakes, but no one. Who would be if you've been 3 hours in the car? Welcome back, Nico, I would say, after a fresh bathroom break.
Thank you. I think he has been in the car for 3 hours.
Yeah, I believe so. I think Sears, Mr. Sears and Mr. Marius are the only guys who actually did no driver swaps at all yet. But I'm not 100% sure. Also, Alex, David, people who didn't swap yet also, I think.
And David Buscom might be in the car too.
Ooh, Piccolo's struggling. Piccolo is struggling, he's losing out a lot, and Sigurd is right on his back. The gap was before was 2.7 seconds, and it's now zero. And that Ferrari is looking really hurt, it maybe from that accident before with Mr. Russo. I don't know, it could be. Or just the tire wear on that Ferrari, but it's looking to getting slower. And we have Brown Deck sitting behind, waiting for an opportunity for them to make a mistake. So he has to be attack and he has to defend. He has to be offensive. And Nico just disappeared again for a period, and Piccolo gets wide and he loses to both. I think it's time to make a pit stop for that. As my voice is starting to die. Still have the battle between Tiert and Brown Deck. Oh, Piccolo couldn't do really much there as he's losing out a lot. I do recall, I'm not 100% sure as I'm not fully updated on the last race results, even though I was there for a little bit. But I believe Piccolo is driving with weights, and that's something I don't know for sure. But I have to wait for Wayne to be back and to ask them those questions so I don't look foolish and talk crap or things that are not true. On the other hand, look at that, just riding the curbs smoothly, and yeah. And yes, again, if there are people with questions that are watching the broadcast, ooh, Sigurd runs wide and he made a mistake again, and it's gonna cost them to Piccolo also. Getting a little bit sideways, getting off the grass, but he's still going. And we saw him doing stuff like this before. And he did it again, just in time on camera. Okay, what I was saying is, oh yeah, I was thinking about, okay, I forgot, but if you want to keep in touch or you have questions or you want an interview or anything, you can contact us on Facebook on the broadcast team, which you just put in Facebook. It's just a page. If you head us up there with a question, any question, it's more than welcome. And then I'll try to read it and reply if I can. As I see, there's somebody already posted and I didn't notice it, so aim on me.
And I'm back.
Oh, welcome back, Nico. Christopher Matthews posted. Oh, okay. He says, whenever I see GT cars racing at Silverstone, real or virtual, I cannot help but think of the segment from the BBC series Top Gear. The boys at the red car 24. Well, that's something I have to watch in a second when I have time. Maybe when Wayne's back, who still has a 50-minute stint or longer to go.
We're close to one quarter of the race done, so it will be a relief for a lot of people that we're almost going to the halfway mark, but still a long time.
Yes, indeed. And I'm checking out the tables real quick to see if there's any close battles. Well, the current battle we're looking at is between Piccolo and Sigurd, but we know Piccolo is struggling a little bit, like a few laps before, I think 4 laps before.
Sasha Sigurd is within a second of it's Piccolo. Yeah,
that's what I was just saying. That's the battle we're currently watching, but 4 laps ago or so, they had a 3-way battle with Brown Deck for the GP Racing team, and they both got passed in one corner on Alex, who seems to be struggling a bit, just not much like before, but yeah, it's like there's less pace in that Ferrari. It looks more, it doesn't go on rails like they say. It has like an own wheel, and Sigurd's there cutting heavily on the chicane, and same for Piccolo going wide. I think those drivers are starting to get tired a bit.
Daniel Schueck is also quite close to Carsten Hoffmann.
Oh, we're gonna tune in for that in 1 second, but the battle is on with Piccolo and Sigurd, and he's diving in the inside. Oh, and they make contact, and Sigurd spins in a hull spin, but he's going again. Oh, dearie me. This is not going as planned for Sigurd. He is really, he's mad, he's flashing his lights. He does not like that. I think he was just a little bit over-enthusiastic. There was enough room, the move could have been made. But yeah, like I said, Piccolo was looking to struggle a bit before. So, you have to be a little bit more careful. It's still more than... let me check, I'm kind of missing here. Oh, we have 3 hours done, so a little less than 9 hours to go. So it's still a long, long, long race. There's no need for bumping and nudging. It only just screws up somebody's race or your own race. But so far, so good. We only have 1 retirement, so we have nothing to complain about. And VE Racing Hassan Burro is in the pits for his 3rd pit stop. Wayne has that position back, and Sim Racing for Holland actually disconnected.
Oh, that can't be long time
that's
ago.
Something we missed not really that long ago. Lap 48, they are 84-0, and we are getting problems as well, as our live timings are stopped. They froze.
For me, is everything working? But there was a moment in the beginning of the race where I was, after an hour or so, where I was doubting if there was a problem with server, because suddenly somebody